Hey everyone, it's Fever here, and in today's video I want to cover a topic that often gets overlooked, RAM tuning. We'll look at the real benefits of optimizing your system memory, but before jumping into the benchmarks, let's take a quick moment to understand how memory actually works with modern CPUs. The CPU cores execute instruction, but to do their job, they always need data, and the CPU really prefers to have that data ready as quickly as possible. That's why it first checks the cache, tiny but extremely fast memory blocks inside the CPU. If the data is already there, that's called a cache hit, and everything runs extremely fast. But if the data is missing, we have a cache miss, so the CPU has to fetch it from RAM, and also store a copy back into the cache for future use. Cache access happens in just a few nanoseconds, and that's why AMD large 3D V-cache on X3D series can boost performance so much. Every time the CPU has to go all the way to RAM, latency comes into play. My memory at default settings has about 85 nanoseconds of latency, and those extra nanoseconds add up quickly and cost performance. Beyond that, you've got a virtual memory on your SSD. Even though modern SSDs are fast, latency here is measured in microseconds, thousands of times lower than RAM. That's why having enough physical RAM is so important to avoid performance drop. Now, most RAM kits comes with EXPO or XMP profiles, which are basically factory overclock settings certified by the manufacturer. With my Hynix ADI kit, enabling EXPO drop latency around 70 nanoseconds. Then there's a manual tuning. My custom profile has much tighter timings, higher frequency, and breaks below 60 nanoseconds of latency. Comparing the numbers, EXPO is still about 18% higher latency than my tuned profile, and the default JDAC is over 40% slower. So, what does that mean in real-world use? The first test is a synthetic benchmark, a custom run of 3DMark x-SPI CPU test. The faster the memory, the quicker it processes the sequence of frame. The results are clear. EXPO gives about plus 5% FPS, while the tuned profiles push that up to 11%. Now, let's move to actual gaming. First up, Baldur's Gate 3 at 1440p DLAA maximum settings in the crowded Academy Square at Inner City Walls, a notoriously CPU-heavy location. At default memory speed, you immediately notice heavy CPU limitation. The RTX 5080 is capable of much higher frame rates, but the CPU is holding it back, leaving the GPU underutilized. Switching to EXPO already improves GPU usage, reduces the CPU frame times, and boosts both average FPS and 1% low average. Tuning the RAM takes it even further. Higher GPU usage, smoother frame times, and better averages across the board. In the side-by-side comparison, you can clearly see how tuning helps unlock extra performance from the rest of the system. You'll also see in the CapFrame X graph, which you can find on my Patreon, that frame rates are consistently higher and frame times are much more stable. Now, let's check The Witcher 3 Next Gen Edition at 4040p maximum ray tracing DLSS quality in Novigrad's Hierarch Plaza. Again, a CPU heavy scenario. At default RAM speed, CPU frame times and busy times are very high, limiting GPU usage. Switching to EXPO reduces those values and increases the GPU utilization. Tuned RAM squeezes even more FPS. Looking at the CapFrame X data, EXPO alone gives a big improvement, but the tuned profile really smooths out the experience. The frame times, 95 percentile, drops noticeably, making the gameplay feel much more fluid. And that's it for today. I hope this video helped to show why RAM tuning can make a difference even on X3D CPUs. If you'd like more video like this, let me know in the comments. Don't forget to check my Patreon where you'll find all the data logs and the overlays I use in my video. Leave a like, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.